stamp like a postcard word to mailman. And I know they're gonna hate, but I don't care. I barely can wait to hit them with the snare and the bass. Square in the face, this fucking world better prepare to get laced, because they're gonna taste my venom. I got that adrenaline.
Alright, so today, guys, I'm gonna be showing you my Arcane Odyssey build. So, first of all, I am a. Wrong button. I am a warlord. Here are my stats. I have 130 weapon, 120 strength, and then. So, my gear, I'm using the Revenant. The Revenant Apostle set with a power amulet, and I'm gonna enchant this with strong soon, but it's not there yet. But once it is, I should have 133 power and 60 attack speed. And so basically, this set, if you want it, it drops from Lady Karina. She is a boss in the story. I won't spoil anything, but she's the boss in the main story, and yeah, so, the weapons I'm using is the Lion's Halberd, the Lance of Loyalty, and the Kai's Saber. If you don't know how to get these two, they're both dropped from General Argos. He's another boss, and, him right here, this sword right here drops from Commodore Kai. He's another boss, but he's not a main story boss. So, the highest damage weapon on this build is the Kai's Saber. So, and I have been using Thermal Fist as my fighting style. So, first of all, when you get to max heat with this, I'll just show you on Centurion real quick. Alright, right here. If you get the max heat, and then you charge the Kai's Saber all the way up with Flying Slash. You do, 338. And then, if you don't charge it up, let's see in a second, you just get the heat. Oh, that was a little charge, but 268. So, yeah, that's pretty much it for today. I mean, there's nothing really else I can show you. So, yeah, that's pretty much it.